Hey, and welcome back. You are in the right place today if you create content online, if you have a business that you want people to know about online, or if you are in the content creation game. So whether you're a coach, consultant, business owner, or copywriter yourself, we are going to talk through the most cringeworthy, unproductive, unhelpful mistakes that people make when creating online content, when they copyright specifically to sell a service, a high ticket service even. I'm talking to you about this today because it happens over and over and over in my agency. People come to me with copy that's just not landing, no one's doing anything with. And there really are five basic mistakes that hold them back from getting the engagement, the traction, the action, the traffic that they want on the content that they're creating. I know you already put in so much effort to your marketing, and it's not even what you signed up for, right? As service providers, as thought leaders, we signed up to help people, to change the world, not to be marketers. But you've come to find out that you also have to master marketing skills in order to be successful and actually get clients online. I'm not gonna just tell you the mistakes. I'm also gonna tell you how to avoid and fix those mistakes so that you do have raving fans coming to your website, coming to your social media sites, and taking action, becoming raving fans that easily enroll into the programs that you offer. I'm Hannah Hermanson, certified success coach, brand strategist, copywriter, international speaker, and real person. And today we're going to avoid the top five common mistakes that hold all coaches and consultants back. I'm super excited that with today's video, we have put together a super valuable workbook. This is something that I only give to my private clients, but I'm offering to you all today because I know the power that's inside. Go ahead, grab your workbook below because it's gonna be pivotal to helping you not just take these ideas and say, yeah, that makes sense, but actually implement it into your business, into your marketing in real time. Like, let's get to work. Let's not just listen and sit and get. Let's put this into action immediately. So go grab your workbook below. The first mistake I see most common in beginning coaches and folks who are just starting out, who are just getting into the online game, is that they're talking to everyone, right? I'm a life coach. I can help you with relationships, weight loss, getting your next job, career transition. Like, you as a coach know that there are fundamental strategies that you can literally help anyone achieve anything. I get it. Doesn't work for marketing. The mass media does not get it. So if you're talking to everyone, you're talking to no one. You're vanilla. I can't tell you the number of times I give feedback on content and I'm like, you're vanilla. This is basic. You don't want to be vanilla. You don't want to be basic. You want to be specific. You want to be niche. Don't just be a life coach. Be a career transition specialist. Don't just be a business coach, be a copywriting agency. Don't just be a mindset coach, be a money mindset expert. Not so much that people care like what your fancy title is, they really don't. But if you can help yourself become more specific and more niche, you will automatically start talking to the right people. Be less vanilla, be more boutique, be more specialty. Because the specialty flavors, the specific areas of expertise that you have are what people will pay more for. And it's that key in the lock to their mind. And essentially as a marketer, your job is to get out of your head and into your paying client's head. Because if you're just talking to life coaches like a life coach, you're just gonna attract more life coaches. You're not going to attract the people who are struggling, who are thinking, I just need someone to help me transition out of this career. Does that make sense? In the workbook, I break down exactly how to discover your niche. I tell you exactly how to outline what you do and specifically who it's for. It's not for everyone. If you're talking to everyone, you're talking to no one. So make sure you do exercise number one in the workbook to figure out your specific niche and audience. Ready for the second mistake? Don't take it personally, but the second mistake I see happen the most is that they're making it all about them. And this happens in a few ways where coaches or consultants will make all their content be self-centered. First of all, they'll tell too many personal stories that don't really have a point. They'll talk about the times when they were crying on the bathroom floor and all the hard shit they've been through. Or they'll talk about all the fancy certifications and wonderful life experiences that they have, and it just doesn't resonate with the audience because it's too much about them and there's not a clear intention. There's not a clear point for sharing all that personal stuff. The other thing that they'll do that makes it about them is that they write content to be smart. So they try to tell you all of these fancy words that they use. They almost write a textbook because I know you're smart. I know you know your craft. I know you have expertise. But the truth is, you're like a professor talking to fourth graders because the people you want to work with aren't experts. They're not at your level of education. They haven't learned all the things that you've learned in your experiences, in your trainings, working with clients. So you've got to talk to them like a fourth grader. There's a really clear table in the workbook that shows you what is professor talk, what is inappropriate, and what's appropriate, what's marketing, what's meeting your fourth grade audience where they're at. And you need to think about it, not that you're just talking to fourth graders all the time, okay? I use this analogy, I have a background in education, I used to be an academic advisor, my partner used to be a middle school teacher, so it just works for a lot of us. But if you think about your client journey, so it's like a continuum, okay? Someone gets to know you, they learn about your brand, and then they start reading things about you. And everything over here, that's marketing. This is when they're a fourth grader, okay? They have a problem, they're looking for solutions, they wanna figure out like, who understands me? Who's gonna get me? I have this specific problem. And so this is where you have to be in their head, talking to an elementary school student in marketing framework. And then there's this little magic door in the middle of this customer journey, and over here is your coaching language. And in your coaching language, you can talk about things like law of attraction or daily habits or accountability or whatever's in your program, okay? Your system, your coaching language, all the terms that you use when you actually start to dig in with someone. But until they go through this magic door, people do not care what's on the other side, okay? People either buy themselves out of a problem or into a goal. They do not put themselves into an 8-week program with accountability and one weekly group call, okay? That's your coaching language. Don't tell them that until they go through the magic door. Hannah, what's the magic door? The magic door is their credit card. Until someone is paying you for coaching, don't coach them. Use the marketing language in which you talk about their real life, their problems, their prison, their frustrations, and their dream life, the goals that they have, where they want to be. And in the workbook, we break down exactly what are the things you need to talk about in your marketing. Because you've probably been talking about your system, how great you are, how smart you are, the steps that people need to take. Hey, here are the three ways to find your purpose. Nobody cares about that until they are paying you for coaching. So you need to do the dream life and real life exercise in the workbook to really understand what phrases, what topics, what's going to resonate with your fourth graders on the marketing side before they go through the magic door and they graduate and they become your college students in your program. This is where you get to use your coaching language. Number three, the third mistake I see. People are unbelievable. You're unbelievable. Not in a good way. I don't freaking believe what you say. Again, I know as a service provider, you can transform lives. You can help someone go from A to Z. But the truth is, if I'm at A and I'm struggling and I'm broke and I'm sad and I'm overweight, whatever my big problems are, you're gonna tell me you can make me be Kim Kardashian in 12 weeks or less, and I'll have my best life, I'll have my best body, I'll have kids, I'll have all this shit. Like, I don't believe that. You've gotta meet your clients where they're at. Again, on this customer journey, they're over here in marketing language. You have to speak specifically to the problems and help them see that it's possible. So how do we do this? Number one, by using that dream life, real life exercise that I outline in the workbook. Number two, by making realistic claims. So you might have a client that you've worked with for years and years who's lost 100 pounds. But if I'm going to come to you, that's freaking unbelievable. And that sounds like a lot of hard work and I don't want to be a part of it. So don't tell them they're going to lose 100 pounds. Maybe tell them that they're going to learn how to consistently lose 1 pound a week. That's believable. You've got to understand your market. You need to be in their head and know, what do they think is believable? Do they think they can start a six-figure business from scratch? Maybe, if you can support that. How do you support that? What are other ways you can be believable? Because I know you guys get unbelievable results. You got to show them their results. So in the workbook, I talk about how to use social proof, how to use client stories, how to use screenshots, how to use real results to help people see what's possible. And this all has to be couched in the framework of these fourth graders, right? The people who are on the marketing side of your business. It's got to be believable. They have to be able to look at what you're saying, what you're claiming, and think, she can do it, I can do it, right? Number four, they don't have a clear offer. This has kind of been brought up in these other mistakes that people are making. And so if you can solidify your clear offer, all of these other things will become less of an issue. It'll become much easier to connect with your ideal client, to get them to take action, to get them to feel like, yeah, she gets me, that's what I need. So we need to outline a simple offer statement, kind of like an elevator pitch. Basically, in the workbook, I'm gonna help you be able to articulate, I help X do Y. I help coaches build profitable businesses. I help moms raise healthy families. Use the workbook to work through what your key words are. Then you can use this headline, you can use this offer statement in your bios, online, in your conversations, on your business card, if you still have those. And it helps you be top of mind. Because if you're a life coach, then people just don't know what you do. But if you help busy moms lose weight, next time I meet a busy mom, oh my God, my friend just told me she helps busy moms lose weight. You were just talking about that. So it helps you be top of mind. You're relevant. Again, you're not just vanilla, like, yeah, don't worry about it. Everyone knows, like, if you get a craving, good luck finding it on your own. But if I know the one place to get super crunch rocky road with blue sprinkles, and you say you're craving super crunch rocky road with blue sprinkles, I know the place. People can send you referrals. You're top of mind. People know what you do. So you've got to have a clear offer statement. Use the workbook to write yours and even comment it below. What is the offer statement you're going to move forward with? Because you never know. Your network is your net worth. The more people who know what your offer statement is, even like our friends here below, the more opportunity you have to get referrals, to get clients, to have brand awareness. You'll stand out. And the last mistake that I see in copywriting is there's no stick with it-ness. This is a phrase that I've coined, and what it means is you just don't do enough. You know, if we were to go to the gym and do 10 workouts, you might feel better, but you're not gonna see results. If you just post for 10 days, or you do a content calendar for 10 months, and you just put it out there, and there's no strategy, and then you just say, ugh, I'm not seeing anything, you're not gonna see anything. So you have to put out enough content, you have to be consistent, and you have to measure your content. So you need systems in place that show you which posts perform the best, which ones totally flopped. Is it graphics that your audience likes or photos? So you need to do enough content to get enough data so that you can continue improving. The point of marketing is not to be the most creative. It's not to be the sexiest. It's not even to be the most different. The point of marketing is to figure out what works and to do it again. If you have data, if you have enough content where you can look at numbers and understand what performs well, what works, what doesn't work, then over time you can continue to redefine, repurpose, and enhance the things that do work. And this only happens when you have enough reps, right? Just like working out, you have to keep putting in the reps, reevaluating, and moving forward, making progress. So don't make the fifth mistake, which is just quitting. You have to have stick with itness. You have to have systems in place, and the workbook will obviously help you dial all of that in as well. All right, so there we have it. Let's do a quick recap of the top five mistakes that coaches make in copywriting. Number one, they're talking to everyone. But we learned that if you're talking to everyone, you're talking to no one. So you've gotta niche down. Number two, they're making it about themselves. Either they're telling too many personal stories or they're not connecting because they're using fancy professor language, just trying to look smart. So use language of a fourth grader and work the dream life and the real life exercise in the workbook to help you define exactly what stories and what words can go in content, will work. Mistake number three, it's unbelievable. You need to make sure your claims are grounded in reality, that your audience believes that that's possible for them, and then support it with evidence, with social proof, with results that you've gotten for clients. Fourth, they don't have a clear offer. They're a life coach. They're a personal trainer. They're a photographer. You need to be able to say, I help X do Y. You help a certain type of people achieve an outcome. So use the workbook to outline your 10-word offer statement and go put it out everywhere. Because the more people can say what you do, the more people they can tell, and the faster you can grow your reach. And then the fifth thing is that they just don't do it enough. So build your stick with itness, build a content calendar, evaluate your data, and keep moving forward. You guys, copywriting is an art. It's a career. It's something people study and perfect and learn over time. So give yourself grace, lean in, have fun with it, and get curious about what is really going to connect. But just don't make these five mistakes, all right? I know you are busy in your workbook, getting to work, which I love. Don't forget to subscribe because I'll continue digging into these topics and sharing new resources to help you connect and build credibility and clearly convey your offers and what you do so that more people can work with you and you can make more sales. I'm Hannah, and I'll see you next time. So go ahead, grab your workbook because it's gonna be pivotal.